Do you think it is possible to do real-time motion capture on Unreal Engine using a cheap webcam? If you are using Metahuman or Metahuman skeleton, you don't have to worry about boring stuff like retargeting. All you have to do is run the programs, connect your webcam, and start moving. It sounds pretty cool, but is it really possible? The answer is yes, it is absolutely possible. Hey everyone, this is Duzgan and I am super excited to bring you my very first tutorial video. I created my channel 6 months ago and I've been waiting to hit at least 500 subscribers before making a video like this. Finally, I hit 50 subscribers in 6 months. While not exactly a record-breaking roll rate, but I guess it is still better than talking to myself in an empty room. Today's tutorial is about how to do real-time motion capture on Unreal Engine using a cheap webcam or an iPhone. We will get the iPhone part shortly, so stay tuned. No more waiting around for rendering. It all happens in real time. You can join live broadcasts, attend meetings, or even become a YouTuber. We'll be using several programs in our workflow, but don't worry, it's all pretty easy. Once you see it in action, you will totally get how it works. I have got the animated summary for you to make things easier to follow. We'll be using Unreal Engine 5.0.3 in our workflow, as versions 5.1 and 5.2 are not compatible. Alright, let's jump into the video and see how we can get things done.
ThreeDPoseTracker is a real-time motion capture program that can track 24 detection points on the human body. It uses AI image recognition technology based on deep learning to analyze data from a USB webcam, iPhone camera, or PD card video. There are two versions of the program available, a completely free version for Windows users, and an iPhone version which can be downloaded from the App Store. So basically we have a primary program that handles most of the work, however, it cannot directly communicate with the Unreal Engine to transfer motion tracking data to Metahuman. To fix this problem, we'll be using a simple program, and it's called VMCtoMOP. Just taking a little break here, the correct pronunciation is VMCtoMOP, but I'm gonna use VMCtoMOP for simplicity. The data from 3DPoseTracker will be sent to the VMCtoMOP. All you need to do is enter the correct port address, and that's all. You are good to go. It's easy. We are getting close to finishing the puzzle. Our next move is to install a simple plugin in Unreal Engine. If all goes well, we will be able to animate a Metahuman in real time. So, the workflow will be as follows. Step 1. Get 3DPoseTracker up and running and adjust the settings as needed. Step 2. Install VMCtoMOP, double checking the IP address and port number is correct. Step 3. Install the MOP plugin, make a 50 weeks in Unreal Engine, and we are good to go. Now, let's move on to the details and start with the step 1. Step 1. When you open 3DPoseTracker, you'll see a standard character on your screen. You don't need to make any adjustments to test program's functionality. Simply select your webcam, position yourself correctly, and you'll see a real-time motion capture in action. You can also use a video file instead of a webcam. The program has many features, including the upper body option, which is perfect if you only need to track your upper body. This option is very useful for streamers who sit during their live streams. Stay tuned till end of the video, where I will share more useful tips and recommend a budget-friendly webcam. Okay, forget about the tips for now, let's focus on the most important settings that needs to be done. Click on the configuration section and go to the other step. Check the Send VMC protocol box. If you are planning to use 3DPoseTracker on your iPhone, don't forget to take note of the IPv4 address, because you're gonna need it shortly. Let's talk about the iPhone app. Just go to the App Store and download the TDPT app. It's free to download, but to access premium features, you will need to buy around $4. Once you have downloaded the app, open it and tap on the star icon to access premium menu. You need to enter your IPv4 address and I just show you how to find it. Just make sure you are using your own address and not copy mine. Type your address here and click on start. That's all. Step 2. To get started VMCtoMOP, check if the receipt port address matches the one in 3DPoseTracker, which is by default 39539. Do not modify the send section. If the movements from 3DPoseTracker are reflected here, then we are good. Step 2 was just that simple. Yeah, easy. Step 3. Open your Unreal Engine project, go to plugins, search for OSC and Counter-Algic plugins and enable them. Then add your Metahuman to the scene. Pay attention to any missing plugin warnings and enable all of them. Once done, save your project and close Unreal Engine. Follow the link in the description, go to GitHub and download the MOP UE4 plugin. Open up the folder where you download the plugin and copy the plugins folder. Then navigate to the folder where your Unreal Engine project's files are located and paste the plugins folder here. Now open your Unreal Engine project again and go back to the plugins and search for the MOP plugin. Make sure it's enabled. If Unreal Engine asks you to restart, just restart. Open your Metahuman blueprint and go to the class settings. Change the parent class to PPMOPPalm. Then click on the body and change your Metahuman's animation mode to use animation blueprint and select the anim class ABP Metahuman rotation only. That's it. Compile and save. Go to the content browser and make sure you search for MOPR in all folders. You will find the MOP receiver. Just drag that little thing onto the scene. Do you remember our simple program, VMCtoMOP? Go back to that program and enter the IP address and port number from the send section into the MOP receiver. Copying is the best option to minimize chance of errors. Okay, find your Metahuman in the editor and search for MOP in the details to select the MOP receiver. And boom, you are just one click away from a real-time motion capture. Just hit play and let the magic happen. You can improve the motion capture quality by changing the settings of 3DPoseTracker. There are a bunch of settings you can tweak to get the best results. If you are just focusing on upper body, you can activate the upper body mode. Within the upper mode tab, used hand tracking option can be found. While finger movements cannot be transferred to Unreal Engine, the wrist movements can still be captured. In the predict section, filters can be applied to your movements. Let me explain what does filter mean. If your character is shaking, you can decrease the Kalman and noise filter values. For example, a value of 0.1 reduces shaking almost to zero. However, if these values reduce too much, the movements may appear like in slow motion. On the other hand, higher filter values can generate some other movements, but may also result in more shaking. If your character will stand still, you can lock the feet and legs so that they will stay still and not cause any problems. Lip size and other blink cannot be transferred to Metahumans. If you need motion capture for your face, you can use live link. For more detailed explanation of each setting, a Japanese webpage is available, which can be translated to English for further information.
Okay, let's talk about the webcams. To get best motion capture results, a wide-angle webcam is ideal.
Values between 100 to 120 degrees work well. The developer of the program, Yukihiko, recommends this webcam, which is currently on sale for $21 on Amazon. This webcam has a wide-angle, 1080p 60fps, manual focus, and acceptable image quality, making it an excellent choice for the program.
I got my webcam for $25. which is here, but it only has a 17-17 degree, which isn't quite enough. Another thing to keep in mind is what you are wearing.
Wearing clothes of different colors on every part of your body can be very helpful in improving the quality of motion capture. Based on my past experiences, I can say that poor lighting and cheap webcams don't work well together.
Without proper lighting, your motion captures might come out looking like a scene from a horror movie. If you want to see more videos like this one, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Feel free to leave any questions or comments. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.